G'day, welcome to Mt.Coramba Apiculture. It's Thursday the 22nd of May 2025. Once I can't say it's a beautiful sunny day, it's overcast, rainy and very, very wet. If you're in Australia, you probably know that we've had some pretty significant flooding on the mid-north coast. Not so bad here, but certainly down in the Manning Valley around Taree, quite catastrophic flooding, and it's shocking to see the river levels down there. Up here we've kind of had a top end of a moderate flood, so we're cut off here at home on Morrow's Road at Nana Glen. We're cut off at Bucka Creek, which is just down the road. The river's not very high, but it's gone up high and staying high, so I think it's still rising at the moment, but it should pull up pretty shortly and start going down overnight. So no beekeeping at the moment. I can't even move, much less open a beehive, but often get asked how do the bees go in the wet weather, and they do fine. If you look at the setup we've got here, so we've got a brood box down the bottom, a queen excluder, and that's a box of honey there. So people talk about dearths and no nectar flow and that sort of thing, and they associate it with drought and dry weather, but up here on the mid-north coast it's actually more the wet weather that causes that dearth. So it just starts raining and does not stop. The bees can't get out and fly, and if they do, there's nothing in the flowers for them to forage, so there's no nectar and no pollen. It's just all washed out. So the way I counteract that up here is always make sure they've got a box of honey. So we've got our sheet of black plastic in here, and these two boxes are quite empty, there's nothing in them, so that black plastic just keeps them snug down in those bottom two supers, and they can still get through the front here and work these top boxes and just keep the beetles in control and just basically look after them. So that's what we're doing. So nothing too much to talk about with beekeeping, but the bees are fine. We'll just go around and take a few shots of some flooding here. Our property is surrounded by water. We can get out through the back here, but we can't get over Bucka Creek back into Nana Glen. I expect we'll be here till Saturday night. Let's have a bit of a look at some flooding and you just get an idea of the amount of water running past here. I should say that the river that runs through our backyard, and I'll show you some video of it soon, is the Arara River. It's quite unique. It's one of the few rivers in the world that runs inland before it runs out to sea. So it goes west from here, it runs back into the Clarence, which runs through Grafton, and then back down and through to Yamba, and they call the Clarence the Big River because it's big. And you can see why, because all the water that's running into it, it's a massive catchment. It starts up in Queensland and all the way down up here to the mid-north coast. So it is a massive river and a massive catchment. So let's go and do a little bit of flood tourism. So this is the Arara River flooding from upstream heading down. This is the next door neighbour's paddock, so just gives you an idea of the amount of water coming through. The channel right in front of us is the old riverbed of Bucka Creek. It actually goes back into the Arara, back up over here, but it overflows when the river gets full. So the river's actually back over in here in this tree line. Quite impressive. As I said earlier, this is not a big flood. You get another 2 metres height here on a really big flood, which we've seen before. So it's quite impressive. So here we are looking the other way. So this is looking downstream now, and that tree line over the back is the Arara. It spreads out quite wide here, which is pretty impressive. And that is our backyard. And the bluff range in the background. So this is the entrance to our place, 235 Morrow's Road, Nana Glen, if you want to look us up. We're on Google Maps. Once again, that's looking downriver, so that road goes further up to Wahoo and up to Sherwood. A lot of forestry up there. That's quite a metre or so of water through there. So this is looking back up Morrow's Road towards Nana Glen, and that's the Morrow's Road Bridge somewhere under there. Probably 4 to 6 metres of water going through there. That's our only way out, so we're stuck here till that recedes. And I think, the way this river's holding up, I think possibly late Saturday afternoon, I think. It's quite a bit of water coming down the river. Let's try and zoom in a bit. Quite impressive. So in the backyard here, once again, looking downstream towards Grafton. Still gloomy sky, but I can see a bit of blue up there. So the weather forecast is talking about clearing tomorrow and a sunny day on Saturday. So that'll be good. Might be able to get out and do another video then, just have a look at what's going on around the place. But yeah, so anyway, that's a look at what's going on here at the moment. Very wet. But, you know, considering a lot of Australia's in drought, we can't complain too much, because I'd rather this than that grinding dryness and drought. It's not good. Not good for people and not good for bees. So, yeah, hopefully the areas down south that are in a bit of trouble can pick themselves up quickly and get over it. We understand what it's like here to go through that adversity. So, yeah. Alrighty, well, that's it from me. Catch you later.